So let's have a look at the string section. The string section of the orchestra consists of violins, violas, cellos, and double bass. Did you know the violin is the highest of the string instruments and it is made from wood? It has a range of 5 octaves and the violins play more notes than anyone else in the orchestra. It is not the loudest of instruments, which is why you need so many of them in the orchestra playing together. To make a violin, you need over 70 pieces of wood. The most famous violin maker was Stradivarius, and his violins have sold for over £9 million. The violin has 4 strings, G, D, A, and E, and you use a bow to pull along the strings to make the sound. Famous violinists include Nigel Kennedy, Nicola Benedetti, Itzhak Perlman, and Andrew Rieu. Here is Nigel Kennedy. That was Nigel Kennedy playing The Winter from the Four Seasons. An amazing violinist, and as you can see, a violinist can play incredibly quickly, and it was making all of the sort of high sounds for the orchestra. Now we're going to move on to the viola. Did you know the viola is similar to the violin, but it is slightly larger, and it plays the middle range of notes in the orchestra? It has a range of 5 octaves, but a more mellow sound than the violin. To make a viola, you need over 70 pieces of wood. The viola has 4 strings, a C, G, D, and A. So the C string is a little bit lower, but the violin has an E string, which is higher. And you use a bow to pull along the strings to make the sounds. Famous viola players include Nicola Paganini, Paul Hindemith, and Kim Kashkashian. Here is a clip of the viola. As you can hear, the viola sounds a little lower than the violin and a little bit more mellow. The cello. Did you know this is a large instrument, too big to fit under your chin, so it has a spike that comes out of the bottom and rests on the floor, and you grip the cello with your legs. The cello plays the low notes in the orchestra. This is known as the bass line. The cello is made over 70 different pieces of wood. The cello has four strings, C, G, D, and A, the same as the viola, but they are a lot lower. The cello also has a range of five octaves. Famous cellists include Yo-Yo Ma, Julian Lloyd Webber, and Jacqueline Dupré. This is a short clip of the cello. As you can hear from the clip, the cello is very, very low. The double bass. Did you know? This is the largest instrument in the entire orchestra and is taller and wider than a grown man. To play it, you have to sit on a high stool. It is really big, as the instrument makes the lowest of all the notes in the orchestra. The strings are about 2 meters long and are really thick to make the low notes. There are over 70 different pieces of wood needed to make the double bass. The double bass has a range of four octaves. The four strings are E, A, D, G, but they're set up backwards from the violin. Famous bass players include Willie Dixon, Giovanni Bottesini, and Domenico Dragonetti. Here is a little clip of the double bass. As you can hear, the double bass is very low and very, very tall. And you could see how thick the strings were, so it could make those low notes. The harp. Did you know, the harp is one of the oldest instruments in the world and is believed to have existed 15,000 BC. The word harp comes from the German language meaning to pluck. The orchestral harp is about 6 foot and has 90 separate strings. There are pedals on the harp to make this easier for the harpist to play in different keys with an orchestra. The harp has one of the largest ranges in the orchestra, covering over 6 octaves. Famous harpists include Lorena McKinnitt, Carlos Salzado, and Joanna Newsom. Here is a little clip of the harp. Thank you. As you can see, the harp has lots and lots of strings. The string family is the largest family in actual numbers of the orchestra. The string family has the five members, and to make the sound of the string instruments, you must use a bow on the string. Sometimes you can pluck or strum the strings. I'm now going to play you a little clip of the string family together. You might recognise the conductor of this group. And that was Mr. Simons conducting at the Royal Albert Hall with his string orchestra. As you can hear, it sounds very, very powerful when all the strings play together. But for now, we shall leave the string family and we will head to the woodwind. The woodwind family. Over the years, this family has grown a lot in the orchestra. But today, I'm going to talk about the four main instruments: the flute, the oboe, the clarinet, and the bassoon. So let's start with the flute. A flute is technically any open tube that you blow into to produce sound, even an empty bottle of Coke. A flute playing musician is called a flute player, a flutist, a flautist, a flutter, or a flutinist. The flute was one of the first musical instruments ever invented and has been used for thousands of years. Ancient Sumerians, Egyptians, Greeks, Indians, Chinese and Japanese all used early versions of today's flutes. Many different cultures have their own take on the flute, and many of them developed independently from one another. The major Hindu deity Krishna holds a bamboo flute. It is being said that Krishna created the world through the beautiful sound of the flute, and that the flute preaches love and freedom. The standard concert flute has a range of about 3 octaves. The flute is one of the highest pitched instruments. Consequently, flute music is written in treble clef. The piccolo is basically a mini flute and sounds 1 octave higher than the standard concert flute. When piccolo players play flute music, the notes sound 1 octave higher. Throughout history, flutes have been made of bone, ivory, wood, jade, glass, plastic, brass, nickel, silver, gold, or even platinum. Now, let's hear the flute. Just how high the flute can go in that clip. Now let's move on to the next instrument. The clarinet is a long, thin wooden tube, really, and it's got metal keys running all the way down it. You blow into a special wood mouthpiece. Attached to that wooden mouthpiece is a very, very thin piece of wood. It's thinner than a piece of paper. And when you blow, air gets trapped in between that thin bit of wood and the thick bit of wood, and it vibrates. And that's what makes the noise. And that's why the clarinet is a woodwind instrument, because you're blowing into a piece of wood. So let's hear from the clarinet. So that was the clarinet. Let's move on to the oboe. The oboe is similar to a clarinet. It's a long, thin, wooden sort of tube. But this tube is thinner than the clarinet. The other difference is the mouthpiece. The oboe has two very thin pieces of wood bound together with a little bit of sort of cotton or string at the top. Those two thin pieces of wood are about the same thickness as a piece of paper, and they meet at the top. And when you blow, air gets trapped in between them, and it makes the pieces of wood vibrate together really quickly, move up and down, and that causes the sound of the oboe. The oboe sounds a little bit like a duck, and it can really penetrate through the whole orchestra. So let's have a listen to the oboe. Let's move on to the last instrument, the bassoon. The bassoon is a very long piece of wood. It's hollow inside, so there's a hole all the way through it, and it's really very, very wide. This size of instrument allows it to play all of the low notes. It's called the granddad of the orchestra because it sounds quite old. So let's have a listen to the bassoon. As you could hear from the bassoons, because they're so large, they make the low sounds of the orchestra.